other day I had breakfast with Al Pacino. Politicking. Told him I wished he was in casino. Politicking. Breathe. Fresh out the kitchen with waffles and cappuccino. Hood nigga. Eating breakfast with Al Pacino. What's good, nigga? Please. My life a movie directed by Tarantino. My Lambo lounging in chemo. I'm at that fork in the road like a...
What up, YouTube? This your boy Down Low back for another reply. But before then, let's talk about something that's going on in the music industry, man. And you know, there's not much going on in the news, but I want to send the congratulations out to Nas, because you know, he dropped that Illmatic XX, which is pretty much a digital remastering with little tweaks from song to song and such, but it's pretty much the same thing as Illmatic. And all these years later, Illmatic is still making waves. Man, Illmatic still commands the respect of being a true classic, so big shouts out to that man Nas. But anyway, on to today's reply, and today's reply is to that Tony Yayo featuring Young Buck, Devil's Advocate. And you know what, whenever we talk about Tony Yayo and songs, it's usually pretty fucking bad, and this is no damn exception. I mean, the worst thing about it is that the Young Buck bust, which he did the motherfucking thing on it, it goes to waste on a terrible track. Yayo never really learned to fucking rap, dude. And it's really a damn shame that he's still putting out tracks. But there lies the whole truth about the game, man. You don't have to have any skills to rap in this bitch. And you know, this collaboration, man, can't say it surprises me. Really, I expect more of this to come. Especially because, you know, 50 been going out on interviews and he's been talking some shit. I mean, he's been talking shit on how they're pretty much babies and shit. And you know, I can see some damn truth in it. Like, they're the type of dudes that ain't gonna do nothing but what the label tells them what they need to do, and that's never been a good thing. Like, they made it into the game, and pretty much whatever 50 Cent was doing, whatever 50 Cent had moving, whatever clothing line, whatever shows, they always tried to be a part of that instead of building up on their own and doing their own thing. And never get it twisted, record labels to famous rappers, they'll always try to tell you what they want you to do, but ultimately, what they really want is someone to do something on their fucking own. But you know, Young Buck, I believe, grew out of that, man, ever since, like, 50 completely cut him the fuck off, and he's been building up his own ever since. But overall, man, I definitely recommend people to go ahead and skip that one. Even though it got a pretty good Young Buck verse, man, it just wasn't very good. But anyway, on to today's article from downloadpass.com. And today's article is how the rap game is a lot like Mario Kart the video game. I mean, think about it. This game is one of the easiest to fucking play. Much like how the rap game is pretty easy to do, it's not very difficult to make songs and such and actually get good with it. Why do you think so many knuckleheads and shit are able to do it? But yet, it's a difficult thing to succeed in. Like, how many times have you fucked up on Rainbow Road? There's so many rappers out here trying to say they're bringing back real hip-hop and shit. Just like in Mario Kart, man, whenever you go backwards, they have a big-ass sign saying wrong way. Because the game is always moving forward. A lot of rappers think that once you reach the top, man, ain't nothing nobody can fucking do to stop you. Therefore, they ignore the competition that's on the way up. While in Mario Kart, oh yeah, that blue shell was coming for that ass. If you get too comfortable on where you're fucking at, you always gotta keep looking out and always keep pushing forward.